So, and then today I'm going to talk about the long chain, which helps them with cubing. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to bring my screen down so you can see my workspace, which means I won't be able to see your comments on my phone, but hopefully I can see them on the laptop next to me. Let me go ahead and pull that up. Okay, so here I've already laid out the long chain for the fours. Typically in the primary classroom, the children will work with it all stretched out. And I have it right now in a square shape for two reasons. One, my space is really small. And two, the other reason is in the elementary, the children play another game with the long chains, which helps them with their polygons, but also is an introduction, like a prereq to their squaring and cubing lessons. So in this particular form, you can see that there's four groups of four. So one, two, three, four, and there are four sides, which makes a square. So if we were to stretch this out with the three chain, it would make a triangle. If we stretch it out with the five long chain, it would make a pentagon, and so on. So here I've already laid it out, and I've already sorted the tickets. They are mirrored in this video, so just bear with me. But first, in the primary, the children will just practice with the counting and the skip counting. So here we have the one, two for the second bead, three, and four. So this signifies that they're working with the four chain. And then from there, it skip counts. So four then goes to eight. If the children are still counting, it's okay. I like to give them the tip of saying each number softly until they get to the end. So five, six, seven, eight. And here's the eight. And the tickets, the numbers on the tickets are mirrored. 9, 10, 11, 12. Now if you notice, this 16 size is a little bit bigger than the other tickets, and that's because now we are at a square. So we talked a little bit about squaring last time, but here we are at a square, and I know this is a square because there are four sets of four, and this is a fixed square here. And I know this is a square because there are four on all sides, and there are four groups of four. One, two, three, four. So here I've come to a square, and I just signify it like that. Then I would keep going, and now I'm just gonna skip count. We have 20, 24, 28, and now we're at 32, and you see the ticket is a little bit larger again. And again, this is another square. 36, 40, 44, 48. Ooh, I have another square. Then 52, 56, 60, and 64. Now look at this one compared to the squares. It's even larger. And that's because now we've gotten to the cube. And I finished counting my long chain of the fours. What I can do now is I can stack these four squares. And that gives me a cube. And I'll show you another way that we introduce this in the elementary. You can fold up the chains to show the different squares. So here I have the chain. I can fold up each section to make one square. This also shows that there are 4 squares in the 4 cube. And here are the fixed squares that go with them. I can superimpose them to show that they are the same. And we can count up all of the beads, but we've already done that with the long chain. And this shows me that this is a 4 cubed, and I have a fixed cube too. Here's my fixed cube. Now the beads don't slide around. And every time the primary children work with this, the more that they work with it, they will know that this is 64. And in the elementary, they're introduced to the concept of cubing and the exponent. And the language that we give them is similar to the language that we give them with the squaring. So it would look something like this. A game that you could play with them. One times one squared is the same as one taken one times, or one times one times one, which is the same thing as one cubed, which is the one, same thing as one. And this is a game that would play all the way through with all the numbers. Let me know if I'm going too fast. Type in the comments if you want me to go back to something that I've already said. Here, oh, and here's the cube that goes with it. And here's the 2 cubed. 2, it's 2 times 2 squared, or there's 2 squared 2 times. And what that means is there's 2 squares. Here's a 1 2 square, and here's another 2 square. That's the same thing as 2 times 2 times 2, which is the same thing as 2 cubed, which is the same thing as 8. And I just noticed this is mirrored for you, so let me switch it around. There you go. Does that make more sense? And then we'll do the same thing with the 3 cubed, which is the same thing as 3 squared, taken 3 times, which means there's 3 square there, there's one in the middle, and one on the outside, which is the same thing as 3 taken 3 times 3 times 3, which is the same thing as 3 cubed, which is the same thing as 27. And the children will play this game all the way through, all the way down. One of my favorite games that we play with them is when we add them all together, and I already took some time to write it all out, but I thought it would be a fun challenge for you all, especially the students here who are watching, to see if you remember this game. So you would lay all of, we could do all of the squares first, but we would lay all of the squares out at random on the mat, and then you would write down the squares of each. So they would do, what is 10 squared plus 9 squared plus 8 squared plus 7 squared 6 squared plus 5 squared plus 4 squared plus 3 squared plus 2 squared plus 1 squared. And I already went ahead and wrote the answers, but it would be fun to see if the children remember how to do that and then write their answer down at the bottom. And why this is really fun for the children is because they like to really, they like to be creative, and they like to stack the squares. So let me show you what that would look like. So here I have my paper on the side. So to do the 10 squared, I'll grab my 10 square, plus 9 squared, plus 8 squared. Kaylee, Karina, do you remember doing this? Plus 7 squared. Here's my 6. Plus 6 squared, plus 5 squared, plus 4 squared, where's my 2? Nope, 3. 3 squared, plus plus 2 squared, and then my teeny tiny 1. And here I've made a tower with all of the squares. It's beautiful. And the children like to build it, and then they like to add it up. And then you could also do the same with the cubes, which would be very large for me to build on camera, but I can go ahead and get it started. So the same thing they would build. Here we have our 1,000, 10 cubed, with the 9 cubed. Here's the 8 cubed. It is so pretty. It's like a little cube. And then here I'm building the tower of the cubes. Oh, somehow I switched my camera around. There you go. All right, so here we have the 7 cubed, 6 cubed, 5 cubed. Oh my gosh, it's getting really tall. 4 cubed, 3 cubed, 2 cubed, and the 1 cube at the very top. And let me see. This can be the elementary version of the pink tower, but here we have the tower of cubes, starting from the 10 all the way to the 1, and then the children can add that up as well. And I've written them on here, but we'll see if they remember their cubes. So they start with the 1,000 and go all the way down to the 1 cubed, which is the same thing as 1 squared, which is the same thing as 1, and then add up their answer there. So, thank you for watching the introduction to cubing. Let me know if you have any questions about cubing or you want me to elaborate on anything. You can type them in the comments below. And then next week, I'm going to do this more squaring and cubing with the in the elementary. And I'd love to see you all there at 5 p.m. on Thursday. Before I sign out, I just want to give you guys a couple of minutes to see if you have any questions or if you enjoyed this. Give me some thumbs up or some hearts. Yay, thank you.